First of all, thank you so much for doing this.
My pleasure.
All right. Awesome.
Aloha.
네, 여러분 죄송합니다. 이거는 잭 블랙은 아니고 아무튼 되게 잭 블랙같이 생겼잖아요. 그쵸? 인정하죠? 그래도 이번 대답 들으면서 많이 오펙에 대해서 배울 수 있습니다. 오늘은 우리가 AL 쪽으로 가죠. 제가 여기 Thank you so much for doing this 할 때 My pleasure 이렇게 대답했잖아요. 그거는 영어로 되게 좋습니다. 보통 학생들은 It's my pleasure 이렇게 많이 배웠는데 Grammatically that is very correct. 근데 conversation을 할 때는 My pleasure, it's를 빼고 My pleasure 하면 완전 더 부드럽습니다.
Gatherings have changed over the years. How are they in the past and how are they now? What are the differences and the similarities?
Ah, all right. I got this one. This is an easy one. I thought you were going to ask me a difficult one. All right.
Okay. 일단 이분 자신감이 너무 좋습니다. 여러분들이 오픽 시험을 할 때 이렇게 웃으면서 딱 하면은 훨씬 사운드가 더 좋고 볼륨이 더 커지고 자신감이 없어도 있는 척 하면은 좋겠습니다. 아무튼 농담은 아니라 만약에 IH를 받았는데 계속 IH 받고 AL 쪽으로 못 가면은 한 이유는 아마 intonation이 the again is maybe not so good. A lot of students will answer something but sound very robotic. We are not robots. We are humans. And so we need to have musical notes in our answer. And so how do you do that? I want you to smile as you are answering. Smile from ear to ear and then your answers will be that much better. But let's continue to listen and see how we can get that AL.
Well, I think first let me start with the similarities. I think
IH를 얻을 때는 이렇게 처음으로 대답할 때 그런 많은 표현들을 배우잖아요. 예를 들어서 well, you know 막 이런 거 아니면 when it comes to 막 그런 거 있잖아요. Oh, by the way, when it comes to를 할 때 많이 학생들은 when it comes to music, when it comes to food 이렇게 처음으로 시작하는데 OPEC 할 때는 중간으로 하면은 AL 쪽으로 더 갑니다. 예를 들어서 Oh, I love music and when it comes to the sound 막 중간에 하면 됩니다. 또 I absolutely love food and when it comes to 된장찌개 딱 그렇게 중간으로 하면 your chance of getting AL is that much higher. Anyway, to get AL you have to first start answering questions in a very natural way and in different ways too. We have 15 questions in the OPEC test and you don't want to start every single question with well or you know those kind of things. You gotta change it up a little bit. You have to first practice changing up your answers right in the beginning. For instance, this person over here starts like this. Well, I think first let me start with the similarities. I think so natural. So this is good strategy to start right in the beginning letting the marker know exactly what you're gonna do. Well, I think I'm gonna start talking about this first and then I'll tell you what I'm gonna talk about next but in a very smooth way. Some students they try to organize the question in a very rigid 뻣뻣한 way. Like for example, oh, I have many things to say. First, blah 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 blah. Second, blah 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 blah. Third, those kind of things. You don't want to do that for the OPEC test. Remember, you are trying to show the OPEC grader that hey, I don't have a script and I'm just answering this right on the spot. So when you're trying to answer big questions, especially the questions that involve past and present, you should do something like this. Well, I think blah blah blah. I think something like that. So for example, let's say there's a question about homes and how they were so different in the past and now. You could say something like, well, I think homes have changed quite a bit, especially with their technology. You know, I think, and something like that. So, well, I think, your main point, and then I think again, and then you continue your answer.
Overall, we gather, and we have gatherings out of necessity.
이분은 overall로 시작했어요. 그것도 괜찮지만 but for students, I just still recommend using overall in the conclusion. It's not that easy to use overall in the beginning. But what I loved about this answer is that he gave his main point right in the beginning here. He says, we gather and we have gatherings out of necessity. Now, personally, I will put that even right in the beginning of your answer. That is much, much better for OPEC instead of putting it a little bit later on. As soon as you hear the question, I want you to answer the main point right away. And then, you know, you could think about it or you could give some introduction or whatever, but put the main point right in the beginning so that the OPIC marker will know exactly what you're talking about. This person, he goes, well, I think, let me start with the similarities, and then he goes to the main point. But I want you to put the main point in the beginning. Well, I think people gather and have gatherings out of necessity. I think, okay, let me start with the similarities. In the past, okay, something like that. If you do that, you put the main point in the beginning, much, much better. Now, this person over here does something amazing. 여기는 이제 AL 쪽으로 가는 겁니다. 보통 학생들은 그냥 people gather out of necessity 그렇게 하잖아요. 근데 이분은 gather하고 또 gathering을 둘 다 합쳐서 했습니다. 예를 들어서 people gather and have gatherings, that is the AL method. Let me give you some more examples. Let's say comparing coffee shops from the past to the present. I think people went to and have gone to coffee shops in the past, just like that. I think people went to and have gone to coffee shops, making it a little bit longer. Instead of simply saying, I think people went to coffee shops. That is the AL method. Okay, let me give you another example. Let's talk about fashion. 내가 여기에 한 단어를 쓸 겁니다. Safe colors. 내가 캐나다에는 많은 colorful한 colors를 입었어요. Like something bright, bright green or something like that. 근데 한국에 올 때는 사람들이 많이 그냥 black, white, navy blue, gray 막 그런 safe colors를 많이 입더라고요. 제가 그러니까 그 대충 AL sentence를 만들어 볼게요. In Korea, I think many people, you know, like to wear and are wearing safe colors because they don't want to attract too much attention. 여기는 people like to wear and are wearing 이렇게 말했잖아요. 그러니까 이 IH 학생이 AR 쪽으로 가려면은 간단한 문장을 조금 더 길게 하면은 좋습니다. 예를 들어서 wear 단어를 ing를 또 하면은 더 좋아요. I think people wear and are wearing 딱 그렇게 연습을 해보십시오.
The differences, however, are that in the past
이분 structure이 너무 좋아요. 이제 past 대해서 얘기할 겁니다. In the past,
we gathered out of a physical necessity. We gathered to survive, to work together so that we could increase the number of years that we would live, so that we could increase the amount of food that we have, and overall live better lives. And I think over time that evolved to be more spiritual, or we gathered to be more connected, things like that.
Now you have to realize this person's answer was actually very, very amazing. He went very deep, almost philosophical, and I don't expect the AL students trying to answer in this kind of way, but I do want to focus on something here. When he's talking about the past, he's only talking about the past. A lot of students, when they're trying to make a comparison, you know, the similarities and the differences, they usually talk about the past and then the present and then the past and then the present, you know, they're bouncing back and forth, wasting a lot of time, and it's actually very confusing. But this person over here just talks about the past, and that's it. Very nice, very simple, easy to follow. And that's what I want you to do. Now, in the middle of this part, he says the expression over time. Before he talks about the present, he talks about the past, and then he talks about as time went on, and then he goes right to the present. In the past, over time, and then present. Very, very good structure.
Even today, when we think about gathering, we gather in kind of a digital space, a kind of a digital space. And even that is ultimately because we have this need to, in some way, connect to something bigger than ourselves, even if it's just as simple as a discussion. And overall, I think that's why.
Okay, I want to focus on the beginning part and the end part of this segment. He starts off the present part of his answer by saying, even today. Now, the key part of this expression is the word even. What he's trying to do here is that word, the even, is connecting the past and the present. He's saying that even now, there's a lot of similar things. Very, very good. Later on, he uses another small word that boosts fluency. He says, when we gather, we have gatherings in kind of a digital space. I'm gonna repeat that one more time. When we gather, we have gatherings in kind of a digital space. Now, what part of that answer is AL? Let me show you. We gather and have gatherings in kind of a digital space. Kind of. It shows a lot of accuracy. Let me give you another simple, typical example in normal conversation. 많은 학생들은 내가 감기가 걸린 것 같아. 이 expression을 영어로 어떻게 합니까? I have a cold. 막 이렇게 말하잖아요. 근데 여기 이제 조금 더 부드럽게 하려면은 I think I have a cold. 근데 여기서 완전 AR적으로 가고 싶다. I think I kind of have a bit of a cold. Kind of, bit of a. If you use those small words, your sentences will become so much more descriptive, so much more accurate, and way more fluent. 그렇게 하면은 교포같이 사운드가 들릴 겁니다. 이제 여기 마지막 파트에 이분은 이렇게 말했어요. And overall, I think that's why, again, the structure is amazing. He talks only about the past, and then he talks only about the present, and then he tells us, okay, now I'm gonna conclude this whole thing by saying the word overall. But of course, he's a foreigner and he uses a lot of fillers, which is good. And overall, I think this is why. Very great expression. IH 쪽으로는 그냥 overall 막 하면 되는데 AR 쪽으로 하면은 the small words. And I think overall 딱 그렇게 말하면은 더 좋습니다. Remember, it's all about the fillers and the small words.
Gatherings, no matter what time period you live in some way, they'll always have some way to be important.
Boom! Thank you so much for that. Excellent answer.
여기 너무 좋았어요. Gatherings, no matter what time period, in some way, will always be important. 나 여기 두 가지 배울 게 있습니다. 이런 expression이 있어요. No matter what. No matter what 뜻은 분명히, 상관없이, 막 그런 느낌으로 하는데 He's talking about gatherings, no matter what, no matter the situation, no matter the time, it will always be important. 너무너무 좋은 expression이에요. If I were to give you another example, let's say talking about coffee shops, no matter what, coffee shops will always be popular in Korea. Let's say hotels. No matter what, hotels will always get more and more expensive because that is what business is. No matter what. 특히 conclusion에 써보십시오. Now the second part of what I want to talk about is the expression in some way. Again, these are nice small words that you can use to get your AL. Now notice the difference here. This is a standard IH answer. You know, gatherings will always be important. Now this is a standard AL answer. You know, gatherings in some way will always be important. Again, it's those small words that will get you your AL. And of course, some idioms along the way will always help. I always say the more idioms you could use, the higher the quality of your answers will be. If you like this kind of content, please, 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 코멘트 해주시고 구독도 해주십시오. This is OPEC No Jam. Boom!